This is your one and only Firespark 81 with your daily dose of video goodness, and welcome back to some more Conan Exiles tips. Today we are going to take a look at the pets that produce resources and what you need to feed them to get those resources. Let's get to it. So there is only a handful of pets that actually provide useful resources. The ones I'm going to show you here today. Everything that I do not show you that's left off this list today just gives you poop, so you don't need to worry about it. All right, we're going to start off here with your normal three. None of these are the greater version because she's the greater version. Your normal three Sand Reapers. Next up, we have the Sand Reaper Queen. Then we have the Shoebills. Next up, we have the Ostriches. Followed by all of the spiders except for the Corrupted Spider. Then we have the Corrupted Spider. Next, we have the Greater Rocknose and the Normal Rocknose. Then we have the Goldvein Rocknose. Followed by the Silvervein Rocknose. And that is it. Those are the only pets that actually provide resources to you that are not poop. Now, let's talk about the strongest of these. The strongest of these is by far the Rocknose. The Rocknoses are just crazy OP. And let me explain why. All of these give you poop as a product. So even though, like, for example, the spider here gives you ichor, it's a weighted chance to give you ichor or poop. You have a much higher chance of getting poop than you do getting ichor. Same thing goes with all of these. Same thing goes with them and the ichor for them. Same thing goes with the feathers here. The thing with the Rocknoses is that they only give you resources. They give you stone back, but they eat the stone. So what happens is if they process it and you don't get the resource, it just processes again until you get the resource. So let me show you here. So if I take a plain old, this isn't even the greater version. This is just a plain old Rocknose. Okay, so then we're going to drag over 5 stone. Now I have this on instant process. So it's just going to keep processing it over and over and over again, getting back a stone, and then you have 4, 5. Now, it did not give you all iron ore, and it didn't give you all crystal, but it divided that 5 stone up to give you an amount of iron and crystal. That's crazy OP. And then if we drag over the silver vein, same thing happens here. If I drag over, we'll do another, let's do 10 for him. Now, if we just let that process, you can see that it's just using the stone. It just doesn't count down. It just hangs out until it processes to one of these. So in this situation, we ended up with 9 ironstone and 1 silverstone. So the Rocknoses, honestly, if you're processing resources, they are where it's at. They are crazy OP because you can just put a ton of stone in there. Look, just put a ton of stone in there and then walk away and come back with a ton of iron, silver, and crystal. I mean, and how hard is it to get stupid amounts of stone? It's easy to get stupid amounts of stone. So yeah, that's it. That's pretty much all I wanted to cover in this episode. It was just a quick little episode because I know it was something that people were interested in and wanted to know about. Did a little data mining in the old dev kit, pulled out the numbers for you. So hopefully you found it helpful. All right, that's going to wrap it up for this episode. If you like what you saw, consider hitting that sub button. I want to give a big thank you to my patrons for making this episode possible. You all are absolutely amazing people. If you would like to join my Elite Crew Patreon supporters, please check out the link in the description below. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a comment down below and let me know what you thought. If you're shy, you don't like to comment, just hit that thumbs up button and show your support. Until next time, thanks for watching.